Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. So in this video we'll discuss the third problem of LeetCode weekly contest 356. It's a medium level problem, and but the accuracy is very low, so let's see why that is. Okay, the problem name is shortest string that contains three strings. So the problem statement says that given three strings A, B and C, your task is to find a string that has minimum length and contains all the three substrings, all the three strings as substrings. Okay, if there are multiple such strings, return lexicographically smallest one. Okay, return a string denoting the answer to the problem, right? And this is basically that tells you that what is a lexicographically smallest string. So a string A is lexicographically smaller than string B of the same length if in the first position where A and B differ, right, string A has a letter that appears earlier in the alphabet than corresponding letter in B. Okay, and what is a substring? A substring is a contiguous sequence of characters within the string, right? Now the catch here is it says that you have to return the minimum length. Okay, so if there are two possibilities, suppose there is a string, just taking an example, there is a string AZ and there is a string AB and C, right? So now these two strings, if you sort them, what will happen? Ideally ABC will come first and then AZ will come, but our first priority here is to return the minimum length. Okay, so the minimum length is this. So you directly cannot just compare two strings. The first thing that you need to do is compare the length of the two strings, right? Like in this case, even though this is lexicographically larger, but AZ will be our answer, right? Because the first priority is length. The second priority is if the length is equal, then return the lexicographically smaller one, right? So the problem statement is saying you are given three strings A, B and C. You have to return the string. You have to return the string with minimum length such that all these given three strings are substring of that string that you return, right? Like for example, just see, this is AAABCA, right? So this AAA, just see, this is a substring. What about ABC? Yes, ABC is also a substring. What about BCA? Yes, BCA is also a substring. Now there could be other possibilities as well, like for example AAABCA and ABC. So AAABCA ABC, now this is also one of the possible strings which contains all the three substrings, you know, as its part. But again, this is not the answer because you can get a string of smaller length than this, right? So that is why this is the smallest string that you can get, right? But this is what the problem is asking us to do. We have to return the string, the smallest string, which has all the given three strings as substring, right? For example, in this case, just see, it is AB, BA, ABA. So just see, AB is a substring of ABA and BA is also a substring of ABA. So that means you just return this. This is your answer. Just see, ABA is your answer, right? Let's see what are the constraints. So the constraints are all the strings will be of length 100. Okay. And ABC consists of only lowercase English characters, right? So first let's talk about the brute force approach. Okay. First talk about the brute force approach. After seeing this problem, what are the possibilities? So there are these three strings, right? A, B, C. So we need some or the other permutation to generate the answer. What do I mean by this? Suppose you generate this substring. Suppose you generate this string, right? So A will be a part of that. B will be a part of that. C will be a part of that. A, B, C. There could also be a possibility that first B is a part of that, then A, then C. Similarly, you can have A, C, B. What I mean to say, whatever answer that you return, A, B and C have to be a substring of that particular string, right? The order doesn't matter. So what I mean to say, if I want to generate, right? If I want to generate the largest string possible, right? For example, if there are three strings A, B and C, so A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C is the, you know, one of the possible answers, right? You can have answers greater than this as well, but A plus B plus C will surely have all the three strings at the as a substring, right? Similar to A plus B plus C, there will be A, C, B, right? There will be B plus C plus A and so on. So in short, I have three strings. So 3 factorial, that is 6 possibilities are there, right? 6 possibilities are there where, again, you have A, B, C, A, C, B, then B, A, C, then B, C, A, then C, A, B and C, B, C. Okay, 6 possibilities are there. this is, I'm talking about the length of all these substrings will be same. All these strings will be same, right? Now, obviously, if the length is same, I have to find out the smallest one, lexicographically smallest one. That is one thing. But there is a possibility that suppose AAA is there and the second string is ABC, right? So instead of writing it like this, I can merge these two. I can remove this A. So AAABC is my answer. I'm just trying to merge two strings. Forget about three strings. I'm just talking about two strings. If the first string is AAA, second one is ABC. So instead of generating AAA and ABC, I mean just concatenating, since these two are common, I can directly merge them into one. Okay, I can directly merge them into one, right? What am I doing here? Just notice one thing. What am I doing here? I am doing this thing. Just see. There is a string A. Let's take capital A to avoid the confusion. And there is a string B. Right? These are the two strings. What I am trying to do is, I am trying to see that what is the largest suffix. Okay. What is the largest suffix of A, which is also a prefix of B. Right. For example, here if you have XYZ, and here also if you have XYZ. So instead of writing XYZ two times, when I merge them, I can write XYZ only one time. And whatever is here will come here. Whatever is here will come here. Right? This is what I'll do. Right? This is what I'll do. And using this, I'll generate all the possible combinations. Look, there are six combinations using which I can join the strings. Right? Now, when I join the strings, what I'll do? Consider I have A, B, and C. So first, I'll try to merge these two strings. Right? Look, here order matters. Okay? Here order matters. So that's what we'll do. So first, you merge A and B, you get a new string. Let's call that M1, merge string. Then you merge M1 and C. Again, using this utility function, right? What this guy is doing, this guy is trying to, if you pass two strings A and B, this guy is trying to find out that what is the largest, right? Length, of, what is the maximum length that I can have such that the suffix of A is also, is the same prefix of B. Getting it? So this is what we want to find out. Now, if we find out what will be the answer when I merge these two of them, right? What will be my answer? Simple. The answer will be, just see this part. This is A, this is B, this part is common, right? So the answer will be this part plus one of these plus this part, right? This is what we do, right? Simple. This is what we do. So using this logic, I can test all the six functions, right? I can test all the six functions to find my answer, right? Because that is how I'll be able to generate the smallest string. Just see what I've done, right? So let's try to see the code. By the way, also let's do a dry run for this one. Let's do a dry run for this. A, B, C, B, C, A and this, right? A, B, C, B, C, A. A, B, C, B, C, A and A. Right, let's call it capital A, capital B, capital C. Okay, first I'll merge A and B. What happens here? Just see, there is no suffix. Just see, this is BC, right? This is BC, sorry, this is BC, and this is also BC. So when I merge both of them, what do I get? I get ABCA. Now, ABC is also a substring of this string, and BCA is also. So when I merge, I get this. Now with this merge strings, I merge AAA. So what do I get? I get ABC. Now just see, this A and this A will be merged. So AAA. Just see. This is one of the possible answers. What's the actual answer? It's triple ABC, right? So just see, the length of your answer and this string is same, right? But again, I have to find the smallest one. So we'll try different possibilities, right? We have done ABC. Now let's do ACB. So when we merge ACB, what happens? A and C. So no suffix, no prefix. So you directly do ABC, AAA. And when you merge these two, you get BCA, right? Simple. So this is not a possibility. So we have done ABC. We have done ACB. Now let's do BAC. So when you merge B and A, what do you get? This A and this A becomes common. You get BCA, AA, right? So BCA is a string and AA is a. I was merging B and A, right? So B and A. So it's BCA and ABC. So what will happen? This is just, these two will be merged. So it becomes BCA, BC, right? And then you merge AAA, so it becomes AAA. Again, a larger string, right? So using this only, we'll generate all the six possibilities, and then we'll just return the smallest one, right? That is what we'll do, right? That is what we'll do. And why we'll be doing it, we have already seen, right? Because we try to find out how many common characters we can merge, right? I can reduce the length only when given two strings, this part and this part can be merged, right? And obviously, there is a possibility that when A comes here, B comes here, I get a larger string as compared to when B comes here, A comes here. So that is why I check all the six possibilities, right? Let's see that. So the function is, I have A, B and C. Now my answer starts from A plus B plus C. I have to initialize it with any value. I've done that, right? This is a global variable for simplicity. Now, update answer for current combination. So just see, this is first A and B, then C, right? Then it's A, C and B, right? Then it's B, A, C, B, C, A and this, right? Order matters. It's all about the order, right? First, I mean you do A, B, C like this, right? Getting it? The position is mattering here. I mean to say, if you do B plus C and then you do A, B, C, then also you get the same answer. By order, I was meaning that A, B, C ka order, right? Combination, you can take any, right? I'm talking about the permutation, right? Now let's see what this function is doing. Update answer for current combination, you pass three strings A, B and C. So basically you vary it, right? A, B, C, then A, C, B and so on. First merge. So first merge A, B, whatever is the answer, merge that answer with C. What is this merge function doing? Just see. Now this merge function is taking two strings, right? It is taking two strings. It first checks that if A contains B, that means you just return A, great. Then I equals to math dot A dot length, okay? Minimum of a dot length comma b dot length, right? Because I have to check for the smaller length, right? No need for larger length. I mean to say, if there is a string of length 100 and there is a string of length 5, right? So maximum 5 characters can match, right? So that is what I'm doing. I greater than 0, I minus minus, right? A dot substring of, let me just increase it, yeah. A dot substring of a dot length minus I, right? Initially, I starts from a dot length. So a dot length minus a dot length becomes 0. Matlab, a dot substring of 0. That means take the whole a. Is that equals to b dot substring of 0 to I? Again, take the whole length. Right? So if, because I'm trying to match maximum characters. So it's something like this. You have a string a, you have a string b. First try to match the whole string. Is it possible? No. Then reduce one character. Now try to match these characters with these characters. Is it possible? No. Reduce one more character, right? So a dot substring of initially 0 to n minus 1, then 1 to n minus 1, 2 to n minus 1, and so on. You are just comparing the same characters with b dot substring of 0 to I. Here you are doing from 0 to n minus 1. Here, right? It's 0 to n minus 1, and here I to this, right? In short, not 0 to n minus 1, rather I to n minus 1, and here 0 to I. Getting it? This is what we are doing. Ultimately, we are trying to compare the same characters, right? These variables can vary, but this is what we are doing. A dot substring of A dot length minus I, is that equals to B dot substring of 0 to I? If that is, what do you return? A plus B dot substring of I. What does this mean? So again, A, B, these characters matched. So A plus B of substring of I. So the first I characters matched. So I'll take the remaining part. So this becomes A plus B of substring of I finally. So you return this. If there was no suffix and prefix match, you return A plus B. Simple. You return A plus B. So that is what we are doing here. Now, once we generate answer for combination, a particular combination, I try to update my answer, right? So get smaller string, whatever is your current answer and whatever you have generated for the current combination. So just see, if the length of both of them is equal, right? Your current answer and the new string that you have generated, just compare them. If A is smaller, lexicographically smaller, return it, else return B. However, if the length of both of them is not equal, so return the string with smaller length. A dot length is less, return A, else return B. Right? So simple stuff. Just do it for all the permutation, right? A, B, C, then A, C, B, B, A, C, B, C, A, C, A, B, C, B, A. Right? And finally return your answer. Answer is a global variable that I've taken. Just to avoid passing it into the function every time, you can choose any of them, right? So yes. And yes, I was talking about why the accuracy is so low. So as far as I think, the accuracy is low just because of this condition, that We are just comparing the string. We first need to compare the length. If the length is same, then return the lexicographically smaller string. Else, return the string with the smaller length, right? So yeah, that's it for this problem. I hope you learned something new from this video. Do support it by giving up a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel as well. In case you have any queries related to the solution, please mention that in the comment section. I'll revert on each one of them. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.